Always found it.
Do you want to? Do you want them to see you? You want them to show them who my trainer was?
No.
Said some good things about you. What is up, you guys? Top of the morning, middle of the evening, bottom of the afternoon. It's your girl Fresh and I am back with another video. And today, I'm going to show you how to make packs. Packs are what we use when we are putting patients on a machine and taking them off. We call them packs. Okay, so anyway, I've heard that it's a luxury here that we have bags because a lot of clinics don't have bags, so I'm happy about that. So then we have chucks. Each patient each time get two chucks. Chucks basically, without trying to, they look like this, they're little rectangles. We put those down under the patient's hand, arms, to catch blood or anything that happens. Then we have gauze. The bigger gauze are used to make the CVC. CVCs are the ones that the ports through the chest, okay? So we use a 4x4 and a 2x2 for that. And with our regular fistulas, that's the needle through the arm, we use like 3 2x2s, okay? I'm really cold, so I'm trying not to shiver, but I'm cold. And then we have the alcohol pads. Each patient is 2 alcohol pads. Sometimes you use more. It just depends on your preference. Then with our CVC, we have different tape sizes and we use the thicker tape for the needles. I'm just gonna be real simple and say the needles. And then the thinner tapes for the CVCs, okay? CVCs also, we have to, during, when we're putting them on, we have to pull blood, like 5 cc's of blood, like old blood out, okay, before we start their treatment. And then we have, these are saline syringes. It has saline inside of them, 10 cc's of saline. And we do, we flush each of their lines, and then we initiate their treatment. Now, we also use, this is a chloro prep to clean the outside of their CVCs around their chest area. And this is a clear guard cap. At the end of the treatment, once we take them off the machine, we cap their CVCs. I can't open it because I don't want to cross-contaminate because I'm going to use this today. But there is a red and blue cap that sticks onto their port and we lock it. I also have other salines for our needles, fistulas. But these are used at the end of treatment when we're rinsing them back and getting ready to take them off the machine. We have tourniquets as well. If you get your blood drawn, you know that the nurses use this to tighten your arm just to, you know, get the vein to pop and whatever have you. And we do that. The one thing I did forget was the actual needles. My bad. But all of that goes together. And, you know, once you get your pack ready, bam. Bam and bam. And imagine, you got to do this for all 3 shifts and you do this for tomorrow's shift. So this right here is for tomorrow, the first shift. We always do it for the next day. Psst, how many minutes am I at?
3:22.
Dang, I did that too fast. Oh well, my lunch is over. I gotta go. I will talk to you guys later, okay?
Right, bye. You guys, I forgot to show you the needles that went into the pack. So these are the needles we use. We got a 17, a 16, a 15, and a 14. These are thick. This is thin to thickest, okay? So these is what we use. You know, we got our needles. And yeah, so this is the missing piece. Oh yeah, by the way, so I was telling you guys about why we pull 5 cc's, and it's not to pull out the old blood per se, but it's more so to pull out the heparin that we put in, the heparin locks, for the CVCs and stuff like that. But okay, that's all. That's it. This is so thick. Then the 15. Most people use 15s. We have a few people that use 14. This is a 16. And the 17 is for like people who are just new with their fistulas and stuff like that. But okay, bye again.
I just wanted to show you guys my trainer. Say hi to my people. Wave or something. That's Kimani. That's my trainer. She gave me a hard time, but she's a wonderful trainer. I couldn't ask for a better one. And she was recording for me earlier. Yay.